morning, everyone, and a very warm welcome to St John's and our celebration of Holy Communion on this, what is the seventh Sunday now, following Easter, and is the Sunday following Ascension Day. Ascension Day being last Thursday, and that is the 40th day after Easter, and we are now in the period between Ascension and Pentecost, which is the 50th day after Easter. So the year is really rattling fast. But we're going to just have a moment's quiet now, gather our thoughts, and then when the bell rings, we shall stand and we'll sing our first hymn, which this morning is hymn number 190. Joined us this morning through our social media. Turn to our Lord's Assistance. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Alleluia. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Praise the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
He has given us new life and hope by raising Jesus from the dead.
God has claimed us as his own.
He has made us light to the world.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Christ, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore rejoice by putting away all malice and evil and confessing our sins with a sincere and pure heart. Like Mary at the empty tomb, we fail to grasp the wonder of your presence. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Like the disciples behind locked doors, we are afraid to be seen as your followers. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Like Thomas in the upper room, we are slow to believe. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen.
Her owners a great deal of money by fortune telling.
While she followed Paul and us, she would cry out, "These men are slaves of the Most High God, who proclaim to you a way of salvation." She kept doing this for many days. But Paul, very much annoyed, turned and said to the Spirit, "I order you in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her." And it came out that very hour. But when her owners saw that their hope of making money was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace before the authorities. When they had brought them before the magistrates, they said, "These men are disturbing our city. They are Jews and are advocating customs that are not lawful for us as Romans to adopt or observe." The crowd joined in attacking them, and the magistrates had them stripped of their clothing and ordered them to be beaten with rods. After they had given them a severe flogging, they threw them into prison and ordered the jailer to keep them securely. Following these instructions, he put them in the innermost cell and fastened their feet in the stocks. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, there was an earthquake so violent that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's chains were unfastened. When the jailer woke up and saw the prison doors were wide open, he drew a sword and was about to kill himself, since he supposed that the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted in a loud voice, "Do not harm yourself, for we are all here." The jailer called the lights, and rushing in, he fell down trembling before Paul and Silas. Then he brought them outside and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" They answered, "Believe on the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved, you and your household." They spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all who were in his house. At the same hour of the night, he took them and washed their wounds. Then he and his entire family were baptized without delay. He brought them up into the house and set food before them. And he and his entire household rejoiced that he had become a believer in God.
Thank you.
be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O God.
Jesus looked up to heaven and said, Father, I not only ask on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one. As you, Father, are in me, and I in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that they may become completely one, so that the world may know that you have sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. Father, I desire that also whom you have given me may be with me where I am, to see my glory, which you have given me because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you, and those I know that you have sent me. I made your name known to them, and I will make it known, so that love with which you have loved me may be in them, and I in them. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. I'm sure most of you here will have come across the television programme Who Do You Think You Are? Yes? Hopefully. Well, if you haven't, or even if you have, it's a programme where celebrities, well-known figures, are taken on a guided tour, a guided journey back in time through their family tree to meet, as it were, their ancestors in probably more detail than they had ever done before. Where they grandparents, their great-grandparents, maybe even further back than that, where they came from, what's known about their lives, and any stories that can be uncovered about them. And sometimes there are surprises and sometimes there are shocks along the way. Perhaps their ancestors did amazing things. Perhaps they saved people's lives. Perhaps they were connected with royalty. Something important went on in their lives. And you can see the celebrities, as it were, living in the glory that's being passed down now onto them by these actions of their ancestors. But on the other hand, of course, there are shocks as well. Maybe they were caught up in scandal. Maybe there was a huge disgrace. Maybe they did something terrible. And again, you can see these celebrities, as it were, shrinking in the knowledge that their ancestors, who they are from the past, have done these terrible things. And the way it then seems to reflect almost upon them. And you can see the celebrities having to adjust their ideas of just who they are and how they see the world and how they see their place in the world. So how do we know who we are? What does that mean? Many things, I think, feed into this self-understanding of where and when we were born, what we look like, where we were educated, where we live, where we work, but mostly, as we find with Who Do You Think You Are, mostly it's the relationships that we have with others. Maybe, well, most importantly, those who are close to us, but also relationships that we have had with others in the past and how they have fed their genes into us. And the same is true of our understanding of who we are as people of faith. Now, in that prayer that we've just heard from chapter 17 of John's Gospel, Jesus speaks of this interconnected relationship between himself and his Heavenly Father, and then by extension, those who came after him, his followers. And he's thinking about the time after he has left the world and the almost impossible task that then is going to face his disciples. The message they will have for the world, actually, if you look at it and what it says, is outrageous. It says that God's anointed ruler, so long expected by the Jewish people, has come, but far from leading an army against Romans, after a very short teaching and healing ministry, he has been executed. And this executed criminal is not only the Jewish Messiah, but the Saviour of all people, whatever race or religion they come from. And this is a message that will get Jesus' followers into trouble. They will be ridiculed, they will be attacked, they will be imprisoned, as we heard in our first reading. They will even be killed. How, Jesus asks, are they to find the confidence and the courage that they need to go out and do that? To talk about him and to encourage others. How will they hang on to the certainty that what they have come to believe about Jesus is actually true? And Jesus' answer is about relationships. Those who have accepted him as Lord have become part of a new network of relationships that includes Jesus himself and his Heavenly Father, and then by extension all other believers. They have now two families. They have their human family and they have a family of faith. They have a home in heaven as well as a home on earth. They are named as belonging to Jesus, and they share then in God's glory. They know not only what they believe, but now they know who they are. And that is where they're going to find the confidence that they need in the security of knowing that they are God's children, members now of this family of faith. Now, Jesus' prayer does make very complicated reading. It's difficult enough just to read it and make sense of it, but to unpick it, it is complicated. But it amounts really to this description of a relationship. It enables Christians now to belong to Jesus, to belong to his Heavenly Father. Christian faith, it implies, is not just a matter of what we believe, it's about who we are. And our task actually is a lot easier than that of those first disciples. We're not pioneers, messengers now of an established faith. We're more likely actually to be met with indifference than with persecution. But still, we do need confidence and we need courage to live out the gospel here and now in our own time, in our own place. And as members of God's family, part of the community of the church, we know who we are. We know as much, and it's in what, as much as in what we say and as what we do, that draw others to Christ. Now we turn to page 7 of our order of service, stand to affirm our faith in the words of our creed. Let us affirm our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist.
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the Church.
This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and
and Holy Spirit. Sit or kneel.
In love and trust, let us pray to the Lord. We wonder, Lord, at your presence everywhere. We have faith that you will change many things. You have the strength, Lord, to move the earth beneath our feet. We turn to you with our prayers that you will make positive changes in our lives and the lives of others. We pray that you will give us the courage shown by Jesus and his apostles to work for your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray to you, Lord, with thanks for the work of all those who lead our faith. We pray that you will keep our team parish leaders strong as they bring faith to us at many times in our lives. They are a reminder of your love for us. We praise them as they lead weddings, funerals, memorial ceremonies, and compline. Hugh, Helen, and Cindy lead by example, your example, and we thank you, Lord. We know, Lord, that many Christian leaders throughout the world suffer from persecution, war, famine, and pestilence. We pray, Lord, that you will help them in their ministry as they strive to promote peaceful, loving communities. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We despair, Lord, of the violence in our world today. We pray for all those affected by war and violent crime. We pray that you will be the victim's refuge in times of sadness and hardship. We pray particularly for those affected by the continuing war in the Ukraine and the shooting of children and their teacher in the Texas school shooting. We are thankful, Lord, for all those who work tirelessly to help, those who raise money to send aid, those who shelter refugees, those who give time in their busy lives to rescue those in need, sometimes at great personal risk. Lord, in your mercy. As the poor get poorer throughout the world, we pray for all those who are unemployed, who work in poor working conditions, or are on benefits. We pray for those who are totally reliant on gifts from others to survive. We pray for all those who send food abroad as aid, and all those who give to food banks in this community and help with that food distribution. We pray that you will open the hearts of those who have plenty to give to the poor. We pray that the leaders of all countries will hear the cries of the poor and work to ensure that all are fed. We pray for all our local uniformed organisations today. We remember those who died in all the wars, particularly those who died during the Falkland War. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray for those who are ill at the moment, those known to us. We pray for Bruce. We pray for all those receiving nursing care and support in their own homes. We pray for all who receive communion at home. We pray for all those on our parish prayer list who are ill at this time. We pray for all those we know who have passed on to you, Lord. We pray that they will rest in peace with you and rise in glory. We pray in silence for our own cares and concerns. May may your living word bring comfort and healing to all those in need. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We thank you and pray for our families. We pray for all those parents who love, guide and care for little children. And we pray for all mums to be. We thank you, Lord, for our freedom and the peace of mind you give us. Lord, in your mercy.
Yes.
Stand as able. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always.
Let us offer one another a sign of God's peace.
Thank you.
present, Lord Jesus Christ, our risen High Priest, make yourself known in the breaking of bread.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is our great High Priest, who has entered once for all into the heavenly sanctuary, evermore to pour upon your church the grace and comfort of your Holy Spirit. He is the one who has gone before us, who calls us to be united in prayer, as were his disciples in the upper room while they waited his promised gift, the life-giving Spirit of Pentecost. Therefore, all creation yearns with eager longing as angels and archangels sing the endless hymn of praise. Supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised him. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory.
Jesus Christ is Lord.
Lord, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You are the Saviour of the world. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever. Amen. Saviour taught us, so we... Sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. O most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother, may I know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly day by day. Amen. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. Alleluia, alleluia.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia, alleluia.
turns now to page 11 of our order of service and to the post-communion. In gratitude, in deep gratitude for this moment, this meal, these people, we give ourselves to you. Take us out to live as changed people, because we have shared the living bread and cannot remain the same. Ask much of us, accept much from us, enable much by us, encourage many through us. So, Lord, may we live to your glory, both as inhabitants of earth and citizens of heaven. Now, for final hymn, blessing and dismissal. You please, miss. First of all, it gives me a very great pleasure to publish the banns of marriage. I publish the banns of marriage between Lee Adam Busby of this parish and Jacqueline Hazel Batty, also of this parish. Many of you know any reason in law why these people may not be married, you are to declare it now. And this is for the second time of us. And so we hold Lee and Jacqueline very much in our prayers as we pray for them for that great day and the rest of their lives together. So let us pray. Lord of love, we pray for Lee and for Jacqueline. Be with them in all their preparations and on their wedding day. Give them your love in their hearts throughout their married life together. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now, let's see what the Young Church, the Sunday School, have been up to this morning.
So what we've been thinking about then, Alex and me?
About when Jesus went back to heaven.
Jesus went back to heaven. And he left something with his disciples after a promise for us. What was it?
That he will always keep you safe.
He will always keep us safe and he will always be with us. And if you lift your things up for everybody to see what you've done, open them up as well. We've got some lovely pictures. Benjamin, all yours up and out. You've done about ascension in here and we've done it in there, so this is our ascension day prayer.
Lord Jesus, when you went away, your friends were sad, so they started to meet together to remember you and talk about you, to sing hymns and say prayers just as we do in church. Thank you that we can be your friends too. Amen.
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 Absolutely.
Well done.
Excellent.
Benjamin, you'll get a clap as well because you've done really well. Yeah. Well done.
That's lovely. Thank you, Anne. Thank you. And to the children. So, before our final hymn, then just a very quick look at the notices. There are a number of things coming up. Next week, of course, we will be celebrating with the rest of the country, really, the Jubilee, the Platinum Jubilee celebrations for the Queen. And there are various things going on. Here in church, we will have the services, but they will have a theme to celebrate. As part of that, we're also having a competition. So, you could tell the youngsters in there, Anne, as well, that there is a competition to make...
Listen.
Just say that next week, when we celebrate the Queen's Platinum Jubilee, we're having a competition And people are invited to make crowns. So if you make a crown, and then we will have a competition, and prizes will be given. So, and that's for adults as well. So if anybody would like to make a crown, I know that we have at least one that's being made. So the standards have already been set high. So we look forward to that. So in addition then to the services, there are things going on the Friday and the Saturday and the Sunday. And if you look on the other side of the sheet of paper, you'll see that on the Friday, there's a street party down around St Mary's, so not necessarily people from here will be going there, but if you want to, you're quite welcome. On the Saturday, there will be a Jubilee Fair, which is down at St Paul's, in the Murfield, details are there. And then on the Sunday, on the 5th of June, 2 till 4:30, a Jubilee Jamboree, again down at St Paul's, and details about how you can be involved with that are there. So that's the Jubilee. We're still advertising the book club, and this is The Scandal of Grace, so written by our own Diocesan Bishop, Nick Baines. And if you'd like to be part of that, there's one up here on Monday the 13th of June at 2, leading on from there, and then also at home with Peter and Ruth King, and details are there on the Wednesday. They will be meeting on Wednesdays after that. Confirmation, if anybody knows of anyone who is of an age or has not been confirmed yet at any age, then we will be putting together preparation classes for that, looking for you to a confirmation later in the year. Very importantly, then, the Parish Away Day is on the 11th of June. We do have a sheet. It's not the sheet I was thinking would be here, but it is one. And on that sheet, if you could put that you are able to come on the 11th, and the details are there, 9:30 for 10 o'clock start and on until 2:30. We'll be looking really at the way we as a parish respond to God and how best we can do that, and hopefully begin to think about the next 5 years and some sort of plan for the future as to how we are the church, the body of Christ, here in this place. So it's a very important day, and if you can be part of it, that would be wonderful. We are providing lunch, so if you have any dietary requirements, please pop that on as well, so that we get the right things in. I think that's all the notices on there, but we do have a significant birthday in our midst. Scott has a birthday this week. It's on Thursday, Scott. I'm not going to say which one it is, but life begins, I'm told, at this age. So we celebrate with Scott. It would be lovely now if we could sing Happy Birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Scott. Happy birthday to you.
So now I think that's all we're going to
say. Can I just mention the brass band?
Yes, we can, of course.
I've got some tickets for Hammond's band. They're on July the 2nd and they're down at St Mary's. And I've also got tickets for a murder mystery evening with supper in Croft House on June the 10th. That's Friday, June the 10th. So if anybody wants tickets, please let me know.
That's lovely. Thank you, Chris. So now we stand to sing our last hymn today, which is hymn number 204.
Thank you.
raised from the dead, strengthen you to walk with him in his risen life. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen. Go in peace, to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.